Welcome to Lynn TV. I'm Lucy Robson, bringing you the main news from Paphos. All of the political parties, except for the president's party, Akel, have called for the resignation of President Christofias following the delivery of a report which attributed to him responsibility for the July Mari blast, which killed 13 people. The former foreign minister and chief of the National Guard were also regarded as having considerable responsibility for the tragedy. The munitions were confiscated from a ship travelling from Iran to Syria in 2009 and stored at the Evangelos Florakis naval base. And this week, the Council of Ministers approved an agreement with Russia for a €2.5 billion loan. The government said that the loan, combined with measures for medium-term fiscal stability, will create important benefits for Cyprus. And 14 new ambulances arrived in Cyprus this week, with one of four new ambulance stations to be created in Peia. 32 new ambulances have arrived in Cyprus this autumn as part of a launch of a paramedic training program. And STET representatives of businesses on Tombs of the King's Road in Gato Paphos want to meet the Interior Minister to protest against plans to start works on the tourist road early next year. The STET committee have proposed ways of attracting more tourists to the road, ideas which they plan to present to the Minister by November. The dual carriageway is to start at the Tombs of the King's traffic lights and plough through existing businesses as part of the Paphos Ring Road works. And finally, the 6th Open Studios continues this weekend, offering a wealth of art forms around the island. Each year, the artists of Cyprus open their workspaces and homes to the public over weekends in October. A full schedule of all artists, their opening weekends and times, are at the website address on the screen. Well, that's all for this week's news roundup. Join us again on Monday for a fresh update of local news.